As the rain on you was grieving, but my gun I'll not need, nor my saddle, nor my steed, and pretty soon I'll be. All there's dust on the sand, rust on my gun, no more campfires, no broncos to run, no more lazy cattle to graze in the sun, dust on my saddle, rust on my gun, sing hum.
You see anybody yet, Ananias?
Not yet.
Till we meet on the other shore, sing
well, keep looking
for my days round the campfires are o'er. Now the long trail has ended and gone is the sun, dust on my saddle, rust on my gun.
Tex, I'm blamed if I can see you assist to all this. There's 100 rangers. Why do they pick on us to nab this one measly little smuggler?
Well, partly because it's our job, Ananias, and partly because it's around here.
Nobody know. No, nobody but Hendricks, and he's the guy we're out to get.
That's right.
And another thing. With miles and miles of border to choose from, why should he come through here?
It's a pretty good gamble that he will.
But you can't arrest a man just for crossing the border.
Well, in that case, we'll just arrest him on general principles.
Oh, General. See here, young fella. When you talked me into joining the Secret Service, you told me we was going to have plenty of action. Why, this is nothing but child's play. Why, one time when I was sheriff back there in Deadwood...
Yeah, I know, Ananias. You arrested 40 bandits, single-handed.
40. Now, there you go. It was only 39. Don't go it. You always trying to...
Hey, look. Look.
So it's you, huh?
Relieve him of his hardware, Ananias.
All right, Mr. Law. What do you want?
I just wanted to say hello.
You don't have to break a guy's back to do that, do you? All right, so here I am. You're all wrong.
I've got plenty on you, Hendricks. All right, Hendricks. Give.
Who is it? You got me.
Who? Search him, Ananias. Hate to do it, Hendricks, but you asked for it. Dorgan, huh? Well, I think this is all I need. Take him over to River Falls and lock him up. I'm heading for Red Rock. You think you can handle him all right, Ananias?
Me? Handle this cream puff?
Cream puff, why you?
Hey, look out, I got you covered.
I'll break her.
I'll pull the snapper.
Jump, he is mounted and gone.
Don't you think it's pretty risky to try to bring that stuff through Grant's Pass again?
It wasn't worth the risk. This next load of treasure is going to pay us for all we've lost, and more besides. I've got to find a way to get it across.
What about that pass in old man Graham's ranch?
Not that old sourball. He'd never stand for it.
I'm not so sure. You know, if we use the right tactics, he'd probably listen to any proposition we might have to offer.
What's your pleasure?
I'm looking for a man named Dorgan.
That's him sitting over there.
Thank you. Sorry to break in on your game, gentlemen, but which one of you is Dorgan?
I'm Dorgan.
My name is Martin.
Where'd you get this?
Jack Hendricks told me to look you up.
Oh. You fellas go have a drink. Have a chair.
Thank you.
Now, what about Hendricks? Why isn't he here?
He won't be able to make it.
What's happened?
Well, he met up with a couple of old friends. From Washington.
The government men. Not afraid of that. Where have they got him?
They're holding him up.
Have you been working with Hendricks?
Let's say I'm his follow-up man.
Good. Then you know how I work.
Well, I'm beginning to get a pretty good idea.
Now, that stuff, is it about ready for delivery?
Well, as far as I know, it is. Where do you plan to bring it through this time?
I'm not sure yet. You see, with the law on our necks, I'm not taking any chances.
We have the stuff ready for shipment.
I said, how soon do you think you'd have it ready?
Huh? Oh. Oh, anytime. Anytime at all. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Stick around. You don't have to go yet. I've got some business I want to talk over.
Maybe tomorrow.
Well, Hendricks, I thought you were...
Yeah. A couple of tin horn Federals tried to bushwhack me. But that's all they were, just tin horns. So I got away.
Good work.
I see you got here all right.
Yes, sir.
I always make it a point to get where I'm headed for.
All right. While you're figuring out where you're going to head for next, suppose we have a little game of pitch. Just you and me.
Go ahead. I'll have a drink.
I'm anxious to see if your luck is still running.
Never turned me down yet. I don't see why it should now.
You know, it's a funny thing. Somehow sitting here reminds me of the days when I was a kid. We had an old yellow cat meaner than a blind sidewinder. We called him Old Tom.
Bid two.
Three.
Your lead.
He's always catching mice and tormenting them. He never would kill them right off, just play with them with his big brown paws. Till he figured he had all the fight scared out of them. Then he got brave and killed him.
Well, I guess he was just a criminal at heart, Old Tom.
Now, you know, animals and humans are a lot alike. You take Old Tom, for instance. He's like a lot of people I know. When they get a fella cornered, they like to torment him and scare him. Just to see him suffer, I guess. Well, I reckon some folks are just mean and can't help it. Now, speaking for myself, I'd have had a lot more respect for old Tom if he'd have just killed the mice right off. I remember one time that old Tom got a hold of a mouse that was just a little smarter than he was.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And what happened to him?
Who, the cat?
No, the rat.
Oh. Well, he got away.
Well, if you're figuring on getting away, you're wrong. All wrong.
Well, I've been wrong a lot of times in my life. But you can't rule a fella out for trying. After all, a clock that never runs is right twice a day.
But you're no clock.
Here before they come back. Excuse me, Mom. You forgot something.
Hold that wheel. That's the third time this week.
Now that you're all together again, I guess we'd better be moving along.
But aren't you going to help me put the wheel back on?
Oh, all right. But we're plumb crazy for doing it.
You'll have to excuse him, Miss. He hates the very thought of work. This won't take but a minute.
You know, this reminds me of a time back in 67 when I was driving Black Beauty in a soccer race in Kansas City. Coming into the home stretch, I was three lengths ahead and all of a sudden both wheels fell off. But did that stop me? No, sir. I says...
Hey, quiet, Ananias. Go get the horse.
Yeah. Oh, say, wait a minute. Here's something that goes with the wheel there.
About to lose your feed.
Do you always sing when you work?
Oh, most of the time. Just kind of seems to come natural. Part of the job, I guess.
Well, far be it from me to interfere with your job. Let's hear the rest of it.
When Brandon Day is done, there's music on the breeze. Times are rounding up a herd of memories. Sundown on the prairie, you're waving magic spells while the old mission bells are. Down on the prairie, your golden color beams with romance and the dreams you're bringing. Tell my riding down the trail. Sundown on the prairie, you'll always be a part of the song that my heart
good as new.
Thanks very much. The ranch is just down the road a bit. Won't you come and have dinner with us?
No.
We've got to get out of here. Did you say dinner? Now, Mom, we'd be delighted.
Well, I guess that's your answer.
Fine.
Well, I guess that takes care of everything. Chuck's taking Graham up to my cabin, so we'll be out of the way.
You won't get away with us, Dorgan.
That's enough out of you, Graham. Now, you two know what to do. You and Slim all set with the dynamite?
Sure.
Good. Now, everything's ready at your end, Hendricks.
I'll have that mule train ready on a moment's notice.
Fine. I've got to go into town. We'll get things moving right away.
Who's coming? If it ain't the Graham girl and them two government men.
We ain't gonna get through here.
Hey, put that up. They'll get through all right, but they won't get out.
Yes, ma'am. We come to see Mr. Graham on business. We can't find nobody on the ranch.
Dad shouldn't be gone long. Would you care to come inside and wait?
Well, thank you. Sure would. Bill, you take care of the horses.
This is better than we figured. We got them right where we want them. I'll stick out here and see if nobody gets through that gate. Get me?
Sure.
Now, you boys just make yourselves right at home, and I'll fix you something to eat.
Oh, may I help you, Mom? You know, I'm pretty good at eating. I mean, cooking.
Why,
Well, if you let him help you, we won't get anything to eat. But I'll help you if you like.
All right, fine.
What'll I do first, peel the potatoes?
No. No, you stay here, but you can help me set the table when dinner's ready.
Pretty country around here, ain't it?
Too many mountain lions.
Well, you ain't scared of them, are you?
Well,
Oh, shucks, I ain't. Where I come from, we got lions as big as horses.
Horses?
Yeah. Well, I remember one time back in 67, I was fetching a bucket of water up from the spring, and I come right face to face with a mountain lion as big as an elephant.
Elephant?
Yeah. Oh, I ain't lying to you. You know what I done? I throw that whole bucket of water right smack dab in his face. Last time I seen him, he's speaking over the mountain for all get out.
That's him. That's the one. I saw that same lion about a minute later. His fur was all damp from that water you throwed on him. Got my hands all wet when I wrung his neck.
What are you trying to do, Ananias? Pull the wool over that fella's eyes?
Say, did I ever tell you about that time?
No, you don't. No, you don't.
Thank you.
play that thing?
Little. Sing, too. You play that thing?
Oh, little. Sing, too.
Let me hear you.
Now, one day, Cactus Pete walked into town. He thought he'd start in kicking things around. But he took an awful licking when he started in a kicking. Now, Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground. One day, he walked into old Sandy's bar. He ordered up a drink and a cigar. Tried to walk out without paying, and he took an awful slaying. Now Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground. That is where Cactus Pete can be found. Tried to walk out without paying, and he took an awful slaying. Now Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground. Now once he tried his hand at playing stud. They caught him cheating, now his name is Mud. He made some awful faces when they caught him hiding aces. Now Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground. Old Cactus Pete, he joined a rodeo and tried his level best to the show. Jumped up on a stair to chuck him and a pair of longhorn stuck him.
Now Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground.
Underground, that is where Cactus Pete can be found. Jumped up on a stair to chuck him and a pair of longhorns stuck him. Now Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground. He tried to make believe that he was tough until the day that someone called his bluff. For his gun he tried to pull it, but he stopped somebody's bullet. Now Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground. Now Cactus Pete is lying in a box. His grave is covered up with stones and rocks. For he wasn't on the level, now he's playing with the devil. Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground.
Underground.
That is where Cactus Pete can be found. He wasn't on the level, now he's playing with the devil. Oh, Cactus Pete is 6 feet underground.
He's dead. You know, you ain't such a liar at that. You said you could sing. A little. Look!
Well, that man's hurt.
How'd you hurt yourself, mister?
Oh,
say, you got a pretty bad gash there. How'd you do it?
I was out in the yard when... That's one of them there! He's one of them!
Don't anybody move.
Get out. Go on.
Yeah, but I...
I said get out.
Drop that gun.
Both of you. Get up! Come over here, you.
Kind of smart, ain't you, Snooper?
You ought to know. Now, you boys are going to have a lot of time just to sit here and think before we come back for you. I want you to think about a room that the famous has got saving for you.
a room with bars. Now, while you're sitting here, I want you to practice up on your singing, try to improve your talent. You hit too many blue notes.
What happened, John?
As I said, they come riding in shooting like demons. Dorgan grabbed your father and was pulling him away when somebody banged me over the head.
Well, where did they take him?
I heard him say they were taking him up to Dorgan's shack.
Where is this Dorgan's cabin?
Up near Buck's Canyon.
Come on, Ananias.
Wait a minute. I'm going too.
No, Miss Graham, you better stay here. It's safer. Those men in there won't give you any trouble.
I'll see to that.
Well, see you later.
Bill, if we could get to that phone, we could call Dorgan.
What good's a phone with our hands tied up like this?
Well, I got an idea if we can get up.
Well, let's try it. Come on. Can you make it?
I think so.
Hello? That you, Jake?
Yeah, this is Jake.
This is Hank. Listen, get this straight. That government man turned the tables on us. He's got us tied up at the Graham Ranch.
Yeah, right away. Yeah, I got it. Yeah, right.
Dorgan, they bought things up at the Graham place.
What?
Yeah, Hank just called. Him and Bill being held prisoners. And two government fellas got the drop on them.
The fools.
Blackie, Bart.
Take it easy with that plunger. Well, there's enough dynamite down there to blow up this whole mountain.
Don't let it bother you. I know what I'm doing. And so does Dorgan. Smart idea, this.
Anybody tries to stop us when we're bringing that stuff through the pass?
Down goes the plunger. And no more federal men.
Let's get out of here.
John, I wonder if you're...
Bart, you stay here and keep us covered. Come on, Blackie.
Snake Dorgan and his men.
Oh, don't, John. You wouldn't have a chance with those men. You get in the kitchen and keep out of sight.
Now listen, Miss Ruth.
Do as I tell you. I know how to handle them.
All right. I'll be ready if you need me.
Thanks, John.
Oh. You're Ruth Graham, I take it.
What do you want?
Where are those federal men?
I don't know.
Don't you lie to me.
I'm not.
Well, where are my men?
They're in there, tied up.
Blackie, go down and tie Hank and Bill.
This is a fine kind of a mess for you guys, isn't it?
What have you done with my father?
Never mind about your father. Hurry up, you fellas.
Wait till I get my hands on that government man.
You had your hands on him once, and what'd you do?
Yeah, that's what I'd like to know. What did you do?
Can I help it if I like music?
You've got to tell me what you've done with him.
Now, listen, lady. I told you once you had nothing to worry about. And if you know what's good for you, just keep quiet. Boys, we're bringing that load through Graham's Pass right away. Blackie, stay here and keep an eye on her. Come on.
What's the matter, Graham? You getting nervous? Why don't you try to make a break for it? I wouldn't mind a little target practice. You stay glued to that chair. Where'd you come from? That's funny. If anybody's trying to pull any wise stuff around here, Graham, you're going to be the first one to get...
Mr. Graham, take his guns. Hold him on him. Well, I guess you'd better come along with us.
No time to lose.
You name it.
You arrange.
Let's go.
Danny, get the mules ready. We're pulling out as soon as Dorgan gives us the word.
All right, boys, hurry up. Say, lady, where do you keep your matches around this place?
Well, there's some in the kitchen. I'll get you one.
Never mind. Stay where you are. I'll get them myself.
There's one score that's settled.
Say, have you seen anything? I... Put that thing away. Have you seen Tex? Has he come back? I gotta see him.
No, he hasn't come back yet.
Well, I gotta go find him.
What's up?
What's up? Why, it looks like Dorgan's holding a convention on this ranch. He's got so many men plastered around here, you can't walk without stumbling on them.
I'm all right, honey.
Are those two mavericks still in there?
No, Mr. Dorgan and his men came and took them away.
They're headed to bring something across the border through the pass on our ranch.
Through the pass? Well, we've got to try to head them off before they get through.
But you can't do that, Tex. They got it loaded with dynamite. They'll blow sky high if we try to stop them.
Get on your horse, Ananias. We've got to stop them.
Ruth, you go over to the Peterson place until we get back. Come on, John.
Set to go, Hendricks?
Anytime you are, Dorgan.
Well, let's get moving. There's no time to lose.
Are you sure it's safe now?
You said it. There's enough dynamite in that pass. If they start anything, to bottle them up tight in a drum.
All right, boys, we're moving.
Follow me. You see, Tex, there's the plunger way down there.
Pretty smart hombre, this Dorgan.
Yeah, but maybe we'll outsmart him. If I could just get over this cliff. But we've got to hurry. Ananias, go get me your rope.
I get you.
I'll set off the dynamite once they enter the pass. Keep them from getting back through.
Catch it, Tex.
Fun.
Yeah.